Greetings, my brothers and sisters from the nice island of Nevis. I am the Reverend Stacia Williams Christmas, and welcome to the Leeward Islands District Weekly Devotions. We continue with the theme, New Beginnings. Our sub-theme is Sunrise to Sunset. Let us listen to the hymn, I Watch the Sunrise.
At rest, only your peace.
Let us pray. Our Creator God, you have formed us in the womb before we knew ourselves. You have been our sunrise and you are our sunset. We glorify your name today that your mercy, grace, and presence continue to shine forth. We feel you right now as we pause to reflect for these few minutes. You are our new beginning. When time seems out of control, when times are good, and when times are bad, and when time seems like no time at all. Forgive us for the things that we have done not in accordance to your will, and we thank you for your forgiveness. Always resetting us and give us new eyes to see, new ears to hear, and a life that will always begin with you. Amen. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our scripture reading today is taken from Psalm 72, verse 1 to 7. Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to a king's son. May he judge your people with righteousness and your poor with justice. May the mountains yield prosperity for the people and the hills in righteousness. May he defend the cause of the poor of the people, give deliverance to the needy and crush the oppressor. May he live while the sun endures and as long as the moon throughout all generations. May he be like rain that falls on the mown grass, like showers that water the earth. In his days may righteousness flourish and peace abound until the moon is no more. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our meditation is focused on this Psalm 72. Psalm 72 is a psalm selected that is normally used throughout Epiphany. As we know, Epiphany traditionally celebrates themes surrounding the visit of the Magi, mostly celebrates Jesus' first appearance to the new Jewish world. As the sun sets, and as the sun rises, what is this new beginning? And what is the inclusive nature of the new beginning in our church's mission work and in the wider world? Psalm 72, then, is an excellent vehicle for themes of new beginning. It is structured as a prayer, and to some, it may have been used as part of the coronation ceremony of a new king. It was new life for the individual who becomes king, a new start for a nation. This prayer then expresses the brightest possible hope of that new king, and may even run beyond boundaries and above what is humanly possible. Hence, it speaks of the new beginning for those who are poor, marginalized, oppressed, and who know and feel that they are wronged. The congregation then prays for the king to rule with justice and righteousness. Moreover, doing justice is that same way that brings equality and equal force towards what we look at even today when it comes to guiding a nation. This king brings new hope. This king brings new beginning to the poor, the oppressed, and the least and the lost, because his sunset is to change and transform and make life better for all. The psalmist then also moves on and offers a prayer for prosperity. It is hard for us to hear this word prosperity, because if we have to think it in this modern time, then we think of prosperity as just being having wealth. But the Hebrew word translates here for prosperity is shalom, which also signifies peace. This peace actually means well-being, wholeness, and even healing. The psalmist reflects the desire that all God's people might prosper. Prosperity in all aspects of life, emotionally, physically, and spiritually, and also economically. And the king stretches out into the sunrise that the prosperity that we ought to have first is peace, because the king sees things with new and refreshed eyes. Therefore, amazingly, within the silence of this all, tells us that the mountains will produce his peace and a new beginning will give the yielding of the land. God's people will have a full worship because it's God is with them. The psalmist cries out for the well-being that comes to a nation or even a world when all of its people are able to enjoy the bounty of the earth and the presence of God. Leaders, kings, prime ministers, leaders of churches should defend the cause for the poor. There is a reciprocal relationship suggested by God, who supplies the bounty of the earth, and the king who defends the right of the people to have access to it. This need continues today in a world where huge corporations are able to produce for themselves favorable treatment in terms of tax breaks and land use. Meanwhile, the weak, the poor, and vulnerable have no one for their cause. Therefore, the psalmist cries out, and the psalmist calls on the king to lead the way. This king is not the earthly king, but this king is Jesus. He has made himself available to the world that we can champion the cause of this world. The newness that Jesus brings to our lives and our nations does not depend on how much we have, how much land we have, or how much money we have. But what counts is how much we treat and charter our new beginnings with Jesus at the head of our lives to make a change for a better life and a better life for others. How we deal with every opportunity as we look with our own eyes tells us our direction. God continues to give us new beginnings and our sunrise moments, giving us new eyes, and our sunsets giving us the opportunity to reset. As we take this idea from Richie Norton, the choice is up to each one of us to have our sunrise and our sunset in Jesus. Have a blessed day, my brothers and sisters. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, as you have given us our sunrise and sunset, help us, O God, to know you as our Lord and Savior, that as Jesus guides our life, that our life will grow abundantly, and we may have new beginnings each day. Amen. We continue to pray for our nations, and we continue to pray for our sisters and our brothers, as we continue to journey through this life. As we close, we sing the song, Reason I Sing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. Have a wonderful day.